Welcome to another episode of the Buzzell Buzz podcast, where we interview patrons to the center and ask them why they like to attend and what some of the activities they're interested in. Center periodically and participates in a lot of activities. So, Ed, tell us a little bit about what you do.
I come to the center. I live in the town here for 55 years.
Wow, yeah.
And I come up here for the center, to see what's going on in the town. You get a lot of information from the senior center.
I know, people, isn't it great to do that? Yeah.
I mean, we come from all different work phases of our life and that, and we probably never crossed each other's path before, but now that we're retired.
Yeah.
And on the, not that I shouldn't say the downsides of our life, but you know, on the quiet side of our life,
we got the time to talk and rest,
yeah, and you know, go over things with different people and find out that we have a lot in common.
Yeah,
no matter what we did in our life and everything.
You'd be
else.
Surprised that so many people have so many different experiences. You know.
Oh, definitely.
They,
yeah.
Yeah, that they've
and,
had.
And I
yeah.
mean, the friendship here is great. You know, I sit down, have a cup of coffee, and that, and everybody brings in a different thing. You know, to
yeah.
eat and everything else. I come up here. They use the computer room.
Oh yeah. What do you do in the computer room?
I do a lot of my own personal things on the computer.
Okay.
And actually, I've been out of the workforce for 18 years,
yes,
and the computers that we had then was way, you know,
different.
So
yeah,
Tony, we said this instructor Tony to move away, but he was great with us, and I hope
he would show you the nuts and bolts.
Yeah. You know, he had two or three of us in the class every time, and you know, that's something that we don't have right now. And I've spoken to Terry before about possibility getting a couple of high school students to come over once or twice a week for an hour.
That's a great idea. Yeah,
you know. And help people, you know, get familiarized with the computer and help them with any ideas that they want to try to do on the computer.
Sure,
and,
sure.
I think it'd be great.
And they're up on it, too.
They're up on it.
They know the new stuff.
They use the phone. They use everything and phones and all that, and it's all new. I shouldn't say it's probably not hard, but you get scared because you don't know what you're going to do.
Sure,
you don't know what happens, you know, if you don't see it in front of you.
Sure.
And then that's the biggest thing, and like I say, and I do come up here on Mondays. They have my blood pressure checked because I have to keep it within a certain range.
The nurse does that once.
She does that on Mondays. She comes here on Mondays for blood pressure check. And
That's good.
And everything else, and I've used the office to. I've used the women out there to help me book airline tickets. And that, you know, on the computer and print out my ticket and everything else.
Because
I know what I want to do, but I don't know really how to do it sometimes.
Sure.
I get hung up, so I come up here and they'll bring me into the computer room and tell me exactly what to do, and I can do it.
They
can
show you, what buttons to press and all that stuff.
And next thing, I have my ticket printed out, and I go right into the airport and go through.
Nice to have the modern conveniences.
That's
great.
Like I say, I mainly come up here just, you know, the coffee and everything else. And if I have a problem, I've talked to Terry a couple of times on some personal senior things, you know.
Oh, yeah, And she's always up on it. She knows what to say.
She knows what to say, and she has an answer. And if she doesn't, she'll find out an answer. And that goes to everybody that works up the center.
Yeah,
you know,
if you
talk to anybody up there, they'll definitely come back with an answer for you, you know.
Well, good. We just wanted to talk to you for a few minutes, and so thank you very much for your input. Anything else you wanted to say that you
No,
do?
I really hope that the new senior center that they're trying to work on it will go forward here. I hope everybody, the selectmen and all that, are on board with it. I hope they are. And I feel that the town, the residents in this town, are definitely on board with it. We're talking to a lot of people.
Yeah, it's our time.
Yeah, it's our time.
It's our time. And
seriously, it's not going to be something that.
We're busting at the seams because we have so many activities up here that sometimes some of them have to be canceled.
They have to be canceled, and I mean the paint, the artist thing now is down at the 4th of July building.
Yeah,
because you don't have room, and you don't get to see these people. Well, and also it. it adds. If you can see them all in one center, you can get to know people and everything else.
Yeah, yeah.
And a good community, you know, quarterly and that, you know.
That sounds great. Well, thank you again. I wanted to didn't want to spend too much time with each of these interviews, and so we're glad to talk to you, Ed.
Thank you for asking me.
Yeah, you know, it was wonderful, and hope to see you around.
I will. I'll be here. Thank you.
Bye-bye now.
Bye-bye.
Well, that's it for another episode of the Buzzell Buzz podcast. Come and join us and have some coffee in the coffee room with some pastry and some conversation. There's always people around willing to share some of their experiences. Bye-bye now.